I'm not attached or married, I try not to be at least, to almost everything that I think. Everything that I believe about everything. I'm open to reinterpretation at all times. And the thing about the Mayan calendar is, what it is the end of the long count. And it's just another sequence of events. It's like it ushers in a new cycle. What that means, who knows? It could be a new consciousness. It could be an astrological or an astronomical cycle where, you know, something in the cosmos aligns in a different way. I mean, we know when the moon is closer to us or the moon is further away, it reacts, it changes the tides, it does things. You know, if there's some other astronomical body that, or a cosmic body that when it lines up with us, its gravity affects us in a certain way and it changes some certain things about people or ushers in some new understanding or new appreciation or some new sort of a natural disaster that makes us sort of rethink the way we communicate, whether it's with cell towers or whether it's with satellites. You know, these satellites get burnt out, so we have to figure out a way to reinvent the whole idea of mass communication. I mean, that's all possible. That could be the reasons why these things, what's thought of that a new age is coming, you know, and that the Mayans predicted it because they predicted there would be a new atmosphere on Earth.
The thing is getting nuttier and nuttier and nuttier as computers link all cultures together, all informational barriers dissolve. Everything is becoming connected to everything else. Not only everything in the present moment, but all past moments as well.
And since the rate of progress of electronics is faster than the rate of progress of biological systems, there's a point when computers match people at which things are irreversibly altered.
I mean, these guys created some incredible works of architecture, these incredible designs, incredibly intricate calendars, and really these psychedelic languages of images and shit like that. I mean, the way they form sentences and stuff, it was very fascinating stuff. And then on top of that, there was all this evidence of a massive deterioration of their society, like it's human sacrifice and, you know, and that kind of shit. Like, what caused all this, man?
As our world becomes increasingly instrumented and we have the capabilities to collect and connect the dots between what people are saying and the context they're saying it in, what's emerging is an ability to see new social structures and dynamics that have previously not been seen. It's like building a microscope or a telescope and revealing new structures about our own behavior around communication.
Within 20 years, we'll have models and simulations of every region of the brain. And we will create intelligence in a machine that matches human intelligence in every way that humans are now more powerful than machines. By 2045, that intelligence will be a billion times more powerful than all biological intelligence on Earth today. We are in fact going to merge with that intelligence. And so we will ultimately become predominantly non-biological, but it will start with this kind of merger.
Watson, who is Mary Leakin.
You're right.
800, same category.
Will it create a robotic race that oppresses and kills all of humanity? Does it allow us all to go on perpetual vacation and live in total luxury? Do human beings become irrelevant or do they become important? We have no clue, really. We can make all kinds of speculative predictions, but we can't say what will happen.
But I think that
you are an explorer and you represent our species, and the greatest good you can do is to bring back a new idea, because our world is endangered by the absence of good ideas. Our world is in crisis because of the absence of consciousness. And so, to whatever degree any one of us can bring back a small piece of the picture and contribute it to the building of the new paradigm, then we participate in the redemption of the human spirit. That, after all, is what it's really all about.